is it then? Why is it then that if the BJP keeps making this into some kind of a fine art, where election after election, in Uttar Pradesh we saw that how Narendra Modi did a whole roadshow towards the end of the election campaign, and it brought in a certain vibrancy to the BJP campaign, which gave the BJP the third biggest victory in the history of independent India in an assembly election. Now, in the context of Gujarat, the story of rural parts of Gujarat versus urban parts of Gujarat, is there really any difference between the two? Sudhanshu Mittal is joining us live, and so is Sanjay Jha, spokesperson of the Congress Party. Our studio panelist there with us as well. Sanjay, welcome. How do you respond, Sanjay? Firstly, we'll try and go to Sanjay. Let me go to Sudhanshu Mittal then. Sudhanshu ji, how do you look at these exit poll numbers? Do they tell you a story that Gujarat's faith, Himachal Pradesh's faith in Narendra Modi, still hale and hearty?
Bhupinder ji, first I must compliment you. All throughout this campaign, you have maintained a consistency about the people of Gujarat being with Narendra Modi.
Thank you.
You know, you had your ear to the ground, and that's wonderful. I must compliment you. And that's, you know, the doomsday seers have all been proved wrong.
I'm just a reporter, I just report what I see, Sudhanshu ji. That's all.
Yeah, that's what I said. So because you were always close to the ground, you had your ear to the ground, I'm complimenting you for that.
Thank you.
Secondly,
not reporters.
Perhaps, and I'll come to that. I'll come to that in a moment. Should these exit polls hold, Swapan? Should these exit, since it's the exit poll day, so I'm not getting into that. I'll certainly get into that on the 18th of December if these numbers hold. But Sudhanshu ji.
Yeah, and secondly, as you rightly said, what are we debating today? We are debating what the exit polls are saying. And all the exit polls together are saying that Narendra Modi and BJP have retained their charisma in Gujarat. It also says that Rahul Gandhi has now once again been rejected. There is a rejection.
Is that?
And the rejection comes for one simple reason. That in marketing there is a saying that no matter how many times you may repackage a product, you cannot market a bad product. So the inherent inadequacies of the product have again got reflected. Because all through there was this major media drive that look, he's come of the age, he's taking leadership charge, he's this and that and that and that. And at the end of the day, look what the people feel at the end of the day. The entire theory of the anger because of demonetization and GST stands exploded. More importantly, and that is what is more important to me, more importantly, the new caste configuration of the Dalits, the OBCs and the Patidars will sweep. Now, this also indicates that inherently contradictory forces can no more hoodwink people and cannot meet with the approval of people. The politics of caste has its limited value. It is not the factor which will lead any party to victory. At the end of the day, it is the hope factor. It is the delivery. It is the performance. It is where people feel their futures are secured that they vote for. And that is why exactly the reason why people are choosing Narendra Modi ji as well as BJP.
Right.
And this factor will always be tried to be underplayed by everybody. That no, it is not the hope. It's not the performance. It's not the delivery. It is not work. It is the extraneous considerations of say Pakistan and Hindutva and this and that. No, that's not true. At the end of the day, The people who are neither politically aligned or active or politically counted, they converge for their future. And it is these people, their choice makes you a victor or their choice makes you a loser.
Okay. Let me hear from Sanjay Jha. Let me hear from Sanjay Jha.
The base vote, Sanjay Jha, not the deciding vote.
Sanjay Jha, the two regional sales manager, regional vote manager.
Bhupinder, we practice the politics of passion. They practice the politics of profession. Now that's the critical difference. For us, it's a mission. For them, it's a progression. So there is bound to be a qualitative difference between the two approaches. I would give my life for my party. I've been there for so long. And for me, nothing is more sacrosanct or nothing is more important than the party. And for a paid employee, can you imagine that there can be any sense of loyalty towards
Sanjay?
The purpose for which he is being
Was
employed?
That a mistake, Sanjay? Would you at least
but
have been
more importantly, more importantly,
yeah.
more importantly, Bukunda,
yeah.
just one
yeah, yeah, sure, sure, sure.
More importantly, when you outsource your leadership, when you outsource your organization, then people outsource you.
But then what does the Congress Party
find
do?
You to be a part?
But I, you know, what does the Congress Party do? Congress is down to 44 seats, 45 seats in Lok Sabha, not going anywhere, Sanjay Jha. And I don't wish to write the epitaph because these are only exit poll numbers. I can flip this argument also, you know. So I don't want to get into that. But yeah, purely on the from the point of what one sees, do you think, Sanjay, that in state after state, is this the model which will be used by the Congress Party? You brought in an IPS officer who's going to look at your booth management. How is it going to work, Sanjay?
You know, Bhupendra, nothing succeeds like success. But, you know, I would just caution Sudhanshu ji from being far too presumptuous, because let me tell you that if the Congress Party were to do better or triumph on December 18th, then suddenly what he calls as profession will beat passion. So, I mean, you know, but I actually have admired the kind of inventiveness or experiments that we're doing, not just in campaigning, but in terms of what you are calling as the booth management. I think, you know, end of day, you know, Bhupendra, you're going to succeed sometimes you're not. Yeah. I agree that you will tell me that well, the Congress has not been doing well for a considerable period. Hmm. Fair enough. I mean, if this December 18th verdict holds and we lose both Himachal and Gujarat, yes, there will be reason to feel disappointed if that is static as it we are talking about today. But don't forget that end of day, Congress Party has won several elections at the general elections and at the state level with a certain organizational structure that has delivered at the grassroots. Hmm. Now, you know, it's true. I'll agree with you that times have changed. Social media has become powerful. You need to micromanage. I'm not going to deny the strengths of a greater scientific precision in terms of targeting your voter. That's absolutely true. Hmm. But I will also kind of make this one caveat that, you know, there are horses for courses. I mean, we all know that India is like Europe, you know, 29 states, each of them have got their own dynamics. Don't forget, we beat BJP in Punjab and we were ahead of them in Goa and Manipur by a substantial margin. So I think these things are, at the end of the day, an evolving politics.
But
and next year is again a big year for elections.
How long will you evolve?
See, the problem is you get into gimmicks. So a gimmickal campaign, a campaign which is imitative of what is termed as soft Hindutva, doesn't yield results because it's the conviction which carries weight with people and not gimmicks.
Utter rubbish.
The problem is the entire approach
Bhupendra, I'll respond
is
to this.
Gimmickal.
I'll respond to this.
The entire approach is bereft of conviction. So unless you are doing things with conviction, where your heart beats for it, where you're
not hungry
you have
enough.
A vision, you,
Sanjay Jha, you're not hungry
you,
enough.
You have a hunger
you're
for
not hungry
agenda.
Enough. You know,
can I say this?
What analysts, and again, I'm sorry to say this, what many believe, what many within my fraternity believe were signs of nervousness being displayed by Team Amit Shah. Actually, Amit Shah believes that the last vote which has to be polled must be polled. And therefore, he goes all out. And analysts sometimes say, oh, this is some kind of nervousness. Now, I have seen this nervousness
story play
out
to put your best foot forward?
Yeah,
are you not expected to really do everything what you need to do to win an election?
So therefore, Sanjay Jha.
Can I answer Sudhanshu Mittal?
You're just not hungry enough.
Yeah. Let me tell you one thing, Bhupendra. I think the kind of campaign that Mr. Rahul Gandhi has led, along with, I think, the three young leaders in the party machinery. I know how many of my colleagues have been there in Gujarat campaigning day in and night out. I think the Congress Party has been, I think it's a brilliant campaign we have fought. But let me make one critical point here. Sudhanshu Mittal is jumping at these exit polls, but let him not try and, you know, trivialize this discussion and make this reductionist argument that we are playing soft Hindutva. I will, as a responsible spokesperson of my party, will tell you this. There is no such concept of soft Hindutva. It's a media creation like pseudo-secular, etc., that the BJP espouses. The BJP is a communal party, and I will repeat it 100 times. If Mr. Narendra Modi proved it during this campaign, that there is no longer any pretensions, the Prime Minister himself is going to play the card of communal politics. I think that argument is now rested.
Okay.
As far as the Congress party is concerned,
if
I think we are unambiguously unalloyed secular party. We will continue to be that. And Mr. Gandhi is very proud of it. So is the Congress party ideology. Mr. Mittal, I didn't interrupt you. Now, it doesn't matter whether you win or I win. You will remain communal and we will remain secular. That debate, by the way, will continue forever. But let me also tell you, Mr. Mittal, the whole of India has watched the Gujarat election campaign.
Yes.
Sir, and there the will whole be a of India has rejected you.
For you and
please
Mr.
understand and accept it. The
Mr.
whole
Modi's
of India knows your pseudo secularism.
Has been noticed
it
by the whole country.
Let's not convert it into
substandard.
Daily TV debate.
I'm sorry about that.
There is a substantive issue. There is a substantive issue at play. Gentlemen, just hold on for a moment. We just want to pay since Sanjay Jha was speaking about these three young Turks. We actually did manage to catch up with one of those young Turks, Jignesh Mevani. See what he feels. Politics of polarization versus politics of development. What was working on the ground? Just listen to Jignesh Mevani. Sudhanshu ji.
This entire theory of conventional elections versus non-conventional election defies my perception of what elections is.
Hmm.
At the end of the day, people have to choose as to what they feel is better for their future. So where is the conventional and non-conventional wisdom involved in it? Conventional wisdom or non-conventional wisdom only hinges on one fact, that people know that where their future lies, and that is what they choose. And if this is what they are choosing, then on a comparative note, people think that they are more, they are better off with BJP. They have better options, they have better future with BJP than with Congress.
Okay, let me take a break.
Nothing conventional.
Let me take a break.
The problem arises,
yes,
that when in light of a defeat, we look for reasons to justify that no, nothing was wrong with us. It is only that this happened and that happened.
But you know, Sudhanshu,
let me put it this way.
Amit Shah gave a call for 150 plus seats. Now, the truth is that if I was to look for a very convenient average, it appears as if the BJP at the least is 99, max 135, let's say 110, 150. Best case scenario is the BJP is where it was in the last election. What if the Congress's vote share increases, the BJP's vote share reduces? What should the headline be then? What will be the justification on the BJP side then? We look at that question on the other side of this break. But as I dive into that break, here's what Rajiv Shukla of the Congress.